So welcome back to the Urban Penguin channel. My name is Andrew Mallett and this week it's lesson 13 and we're going to look at the RPM file format and managing software with RPM. So like always, I'm trying to keep these presentations relevant and something that will fit with you at home and you at work. So of course, we've looked at software management before using openSUSE and zypper. But if you don't have the software that you want, you can download it. So here on the Adobe website, I can download the Acrobat Reader. To be honest, it is included with a lot of distributions, including openSUSE. But if I go back, let's say to my command prompt, and if we search for Acrobat, so zypper search Acro, so I was looking for anything that starts A-C-R-O, we can see that we've got the Acrobat Reader, but it's not installed. This would be getting it from the repository. Getting it direct from Adobe means that we know we're getting the latest version that's available. When we look at it, we can download it in a binary format where we just execute the program. A Debian format, so these are typically for Debian operating systems and also for Ubuntu, RPM, or a tar BZ2 where we have to unzip the image and then run an installer. So it's typical on a lot of Linux machines that we can work with RPM files or Red Hat Package Manager. Doesn't matter that your system's not Red Hat, yeah, this is openSUSE, but it will still work with RPM files. So most software that we put on are in the form of .rpm files. So I just go to the Adobe site. I then, of course, download the RPM. I'll save it. I won't actually use the software to install it straight away. So we just go OK. And of course, then it's downloading. Once it has downloaded, I can then right click and then we can open up the containing folder. So we can see then that it's gone through into my downloads directory. Of course, I can go through then and I can open with, and then again, it's going to allow me to open it up with a KDE installer or through the Yast installer. But we really want to look at how we would manage it, let's say from the command line and how RPM files work. So then back at my command prompt, I can go CD and then downloads, LS to list the content, we can see the RPM file. And to install this, I would need root privileges. So I'm just going to do an SU. I won't do the SU minus because I want to actually stay in this directory. So SU switches user. If I don't specify the user account, it switches to the root user. If I use SU minus, it runs a login script for that user and would take me through to the root user's home directory. So if I just go SU, put in the root user's password. And of course, it keeps me in that directory. So I do then an RPM and then minus I to install and then just use capital A and tab completion. I've got only one file in this directory. So this would of course install. As it's going through, you can see that it's not really showing me any progress. If I wanted to, I could turn on progress bars, little hash marks, so we could see at least something was happening. If I wanted to remove it, then it would be RPM and then minus E. And then the name of the package I want to remove. Well, here it was the RPM file, but we have to know what the actual package is called. So if I do a query all, and then grep for Adobe. Then we can see the name of the package there, Adobe Reader. So here we've got then Adobe Reader minus 9.5. Generally, I don't need to worry about the rest of the numbers. So I can then do an RPM minus E for erase. And I'm just going to be lazy and copy this across. And again, then it's removing it. So we've got minus I to install, minus E to remove. We could also use things like minus F to freshen or minus U to update if the software was already installed. And as I say, we'll look at installing it again in a few moments, but we'll do it with hash marks so we can see the progress. So once that finished, I just did Control L to clear the screen. If I want to then run the install again, if I just do Control R and then let's say minus I, it then puts my install command back on. If I hit escape, it allows me to edit the command, then I can add in the H option and then hit enter. With this then we get progress bars, so I can at least see that something is going ahead. So it gives me, I suppose, better feedback. But of course, I'm doing this through a script, I might not be watching, so there's no need to particularly put the H marks on. But there we can see now that it's installed, and I can see during the install the progress with the minus H switch for the hashes. Now that the package is installed, there's lots more we can play around, not just obviously removing it. But then if I do a Control R to search my history, and then if I put in, say, Adobe, we can see then we've got the minus E to erase it. I'm going to change that. Instead of the minus E, I'm going to go minus query. And if we say query L, we will list everything that was put on with it. So we can see that all of these elements came with that package. RPM is a database in itself, and the RPM files are written to an RPM database. So I don't need uninstallers to take them out. We go to the database and we can remove what we put in. It also means that if I go through into one of these files, obviously they're fairly obvious where they came from because they're in the Adobe Reader directory, but I can also query a file. Rather than say querying one of those files, if I went into, let's say, cd/etc, just do an ls here, and we might want to say, well, yeah, where did the nsswitch.conf from, the nameserviceswitch.conf file come from? I could then do, let's just clear the screen, rpm minus query file nsswitch.conf, and then it tells me that that came from the glibc package. So we can query a file, we can query a package. But we can also verify packages to see if anything has changed. So we could do an RPM minus query, RPM minus capital V for verify, and then specify the name of the package or A for all, and then hit enter. So as it starts running through, it can check files that have been modified since they were installed. So it's checking against the database and the installed files and then seeing which ones are different. If I just Control C to stop this now, we can see that the VNC file has changed. the etc default user add file has changed, and then in the NTP conf file has changed. We're not really bothered about it because looking at here, all the C means is a configuration file. So here the timestamp has changed. Here we're looking at the MD5 checksum has changed. Here we're looking at the size of the file has changed. But if these things had been binaries rather than configuration files, maybe it's an indication something untoward has been happening. So again, we can use the software installation programs through Yast or what other programs you have, but using the raw RPM commands gives you a lot more information about the file and what's installed and how we can manage the programs. Hopefully you found this useful, and thank you very much.